Should go all the way. Should go all the way. Yes. Good result for Dumini and the Trident. Hero maximum.
He's not a big man, but he possesses all the qualities, the power and the timing. And this is JP Dumini at his best. Not that short. Picks up on it and gives it a good whack.
All right, we're in the 17th over now. What do you reckon would be a good score here if he all to place?
I reckon 150, 160. If we get to 170, that would be good. And that's another six. So that's six less runs that we have to worry about.
Well done, Jonathan.
Thank you very much.
Bang on the Republic Bank fan stand. JP Dumini finding the middle of his bat. The second time, hero maximum for him.
Quick hands from Dumini. Gets onto that back foot quickly and takes advantage of a drag down slow ball. He can pack a punch, JP. There's no question of that. He's not a big man in stature, but he does hit a long ball when he gets set, and he needs to hit a few here if they're wanting to reach that 160 mark.
Well, this year's strike rate in the last five overs for the Tridents around 170. Exactly what the Tridents need at this stage of the innings. And again. Simply brilliant from Dumini, over extra cover this time. Hero maximum, smash.
Yeah, the little man's on the charge now. He's got his tail up, and that is a brilliant shot. Over extra cover. As good as you're going to see. Out to the long side too, thank you very much. It's a good 70 plus meter hit from where he struck it. Where the first six was hit to the shorter side, so his leg side is the shorter side as he's facing now. And Ali Khan is adjusting his line now. He's around the wicket.
Where will he go now? Where will he go? Goes full, goes straight, and Dumini has the skill to get a boundary.
Yeah, this is poor from Ali Khan. He started off poorly, and he's come back poorly. 44 now for 2.4 overs, and his captain's got his hands on his hips. Where does he go from here? JP Dumini, well, he's taking full advantage. It's excellent batting at the death here. I just question Ali Khan's thinking around the line of the delivery. The execution, I think he's got absolutely right, because he got a Yorker on the crease line. And I think that that's exactly what he was looking for. But with a third man that's very wide. JP Dumini, he's just hit three sixes in a row. Not in a row, but over a very short period of time. And that's that delivery. It was full, it was right in the Yorker area, but the line of it was incorrect, with a third man that's very, very wide. Their third man is a backward point, and they've got third man in on the ring. So JP Dumini just needs to open the face of the bat and take full advantage of that field placement.
And also pace on the ball as well. He might want to take the pace off. Straight. Another one for Dumini.
Well, I thought he hit a long golf ball when I played with him yesterday, but this is something exceptional. This is JP Dumini, the old JP Dumini. He's got his tail up and he's going. Ali Khan's under serious pressure. It's another full toss. And it's another attempt at a one-handed catch. Forget 160. We're just 10 shy, or 8 shy of that. On target for 170 plus now. Good news for Tridents fans.
11.3 is economy in this edition of Hero CPL.
Yeah, we're looking at this field. He's probably going to bowl a little bit straighter than he has in previous matches. He's bowled quite wide, gone for a lot of runs. So expect him to try and tuck up Dumini here. Bowl towards his pads.
Goes through the offside. Immaculate timing. This guy is on fire.
Well, this shot belongs in any version of the game, whether it's a test match, 50 over, or a hero CPL match. That is a proper cricket shot. Off-pace delivery, little bit of width on offer. Dumini waiting for it and crunching it behind point.
Pressure on for Jimmy Neesham.
And again, my word, JP Dumini can do anything wrong tonight.
Well, poor Jimmy Neesham, he keeps going the distance, and this is one of the fastest 50s in this year's CPL. It's a back of the hand slower ball. He picks it up quite magnificently, deposits that way over mid on.
Poor old Jimmy Neesham, on his birthday, his first over went for 31. He's also had mixed fortunes because he's taken plenty of wickets as well. But looking at the fastest 50s this year, Evan Lewis, who's been in great form, just 17 balls. So JP Dumini, sitting on 14, is on track.
And again, that's it, that's the record for the fastest 50 ever in CPL. Dumini, excellence tonight.
Well, he talks about his new carefree attitude, international cricket off his shoulders, and he's really enjoying his cricket. And it means so much to him. He's played with freedom, he's played with power, and he's hit a lot of these hero maximums.
And in doing so, he has recovered his side's hopes of having a competitive total, because they were on track for a total around about that 180 mark, and they fell in a hole, and he's dug them out of that hole.
JP Dumini, we've discussed the fact that you were going to play a role in this team to be the elder statesman. You've only gone and had the fastest CPL 50 of all time. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Very pleased with that batting performance after, you know, as a group we've been discussing a lot in this tournament about putting a big effort in. So we set the game up nicely. That opening partnership really set the game up for us. You know, coming into this game with probably 10 batters, we could risk a few early on there, sort of in the middle phases. So for me it was just about seeing the ball quite clearly, understanding what the bowler was trying to do and just trying to execute.
JP, wickets fell all around you. It was a good opening stand, but then three really quick wickets, and then you proceeded to destroy the boiling, 65 off 20, massive strike rate.
Yeah, I guess the benefit we had was we lost our first wicket, I think, in the 12th or 13th over. So we lost three wickets, yes, but when I sort of identified, right, it's time to go, there were 16 gone already. So that's generally in a T20 game, you're going to try and take it on anyway. So the game was set up nicely for us.
Can you talk me through the Jimmy Neesham over?
Yeah, I've obviously faced him quite a few times in international cricket, so I understand what he's trying to do, particularly against me. He's had one over me a few times in international cricket, so it was good to get one over him tonight.
Well, it's a big number. It would be the highest ever run chase to be achieved here. How do you go about defending it?
Yeah, there's still a little bit in that wicket there. It's a little bit on the slow side. We've seen in the first two games how the wicket slows up in the back half of the game, so we've got to use that to our advantage coming in the second innings.
Best of luck. Well done.
Thank you.